This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Canadian raising is a vowel shift in many dialects of North American English that changes the pronunciation of diphthongs with open vowel starting points. Most commonly, the shift affects I, ah, or I, ah, or both, when they are pronounced before voiceless consonants. Therefore, in words like pair and are not complete homophones. Contents 1. Description 11. Phonetic environment 12. Result 2. Geographic distribution 3. Possible origins 4. See also 5. Notes 6. Bibliography. Description. Examples of Canadian raising in American English. Writer, writer without raising, with it. High school, secondary school, with raising, school that is high up, without it. Bout, bout without raising, with it. About, a boot, a boat with raising, compared with oo in and o in. Problems playing these files. See media help. Phonetic environment in general, Canadian raising affects vowels before voiceless consonants like f, theta, t, and s. Vowels before voiced consonants like v, d, and z, are usually not raised. This rule, however, is not completely accurate. A study of three speakers in Meaford, Ontario shows that pronunciation of the diphthong ah falls on a continuum between raised and unraised. Raising is influenced by voicing of the following consonant, but it also appears to be influenced by the sound before the diphthong. Frequently the diphthong is raised when it is preceded by a coronal, in gigantic, dinosaur, and Siberia. Raising before r, as in wire, iris, and fire, has been noted in some American accents. Raising of a before voiced consonants is particularly advanced in the inland north, north central American English, and Philadelphia dialect areas, especially, and hence, words like tiny, spider, cider, tiger, dinosaur, cyber, beside, idle but sometimes not idle, and fire may contain a raised nucleus. The use of rather than in such words is unpredictable from phonetic environment alone, though it may have to do with their acoustic similarity to other words that do contain before a voiceless consonant. Per the traditional Canadian raising system, hence, some researchers have argued that there has been a phonemic split in these dialects. The distribution of the two sounds is becoming more unpredictable among younger speakers. Raising can apply to compound words. Hence, high school is a term meaning a secondary school for students approximately 14 to 18 years old. The vowel in high may be raised, whereas high school with the literal meaning of a school that is high, e.g. in elevation, is unaffected. The two terms are also distinguished by the position of the stress accent, as shown. The same is true of high chair. However, frequently it does not. One study of speakers in Rochester, New York and Minnesota found a very inconsistent pattern of ah raising before voiceless consonants in certain prefixes. For example, the numerical prefix bi was raised in bicycle but not bisexual or bifocals. Likewise, the vowel was consistently kept low when used in a prefix in words like dichotomy, mitosis, and anti-Semitic. This pattern may have to do with stress or familiarity of the word to the speaker. However, these relations are still inconsistent. Intervocalic alveolar flapping occurs in most dialects of North American English. Through this change, T and D between vowels are both pronounced as an alveolar flap. Alveolar flapping occurs after Canadian raising, so writer has a raised vowel and rider does not, and these words are distinguished by their vowels, even though they both have a flapped in British English, such as received pronunciation. Neither flapping nor raising occur, so these words would have different consonants and identical vowels, except for a slight difference in length, and result the raised variant of a typically becomes, while the raised variant of a varies by dialect, with more common in Western Canada and a fronted variant commonly heard in Central Canada. In any case, the component of the diphthong changes from a low vowel to a mid-low vowel, or geographic distribution. Despite its name, Canadian raising is not restricted to Canada. Raising of both a and a is common in eastern New England, for example in Boston, as well as in the upper Midwest South Atlantic English and the accents of England's Fens. Feature it as well. Raising of just ah is found throughout the United States, and so may be considered an increasingly common general American characteristic, with the only major exception in the U.S. being in the South. There is considerable variation in this one type of Canadian raising's application and phonetic effects in the U.S., where it is believed to have spread from the North, and so most prominently includes the English of northern U.S. regions like New England, the inland North, Philadelphia, and New York City. It also appears in Western American, including California. California English. Even some speakers in the South undergo this form of Canadian raising, though, more commonly, Southern American English as well as African American vernacular and Afro-Bahamian English demonstrates a distinct but related phenomenon that splits, ah, by retaining the glide before voiceless consonants and weakening the glide elsewhere. The raising of, ah, is also present in Ulster English, spoken in the northern region of the island of Ireland, in which, ah, is split between the sound before voiced consonants or in final position and the sound before voiceless consonants but also sometimes in any position. Phonologist Raymond Hickey has described this Ulster raising as embryonically the situation for Canadian raising. There are also Canadians who raise only ah, but not ah, or vice versa. Possible origins. The most common understanding of the great vowel shift is that the Middle English vowels passed through a stage on the way to their modern pronunciations, ah, ah. Given its prevalence in areas of North America first settled by native English speakers, it is possible this is not an innovation of raising from an underlying vowel quality to another in the least, but, rather, of the preservation of an older vowel quality in a restricted environment. See also Canada Portal Linguistics Portal Canadian Shift North American English Regional Phonology Notes Carrot Hall 2005 Carrot Vance 1987 Carrot Freywald, Joseph T. November 11, 2007 The Spread of Raising, Opacity, Lexicalization, and Diffusion. University of Pennsylvania retrieved September 21, 2016. Raising in some dialects of the Northern United States. University of Hawaii at Manoa retrieved September 26, 2016. Conference on Formal Linguistics Somerville, Massachusetts, Cascadilla Proceedings Project ISBN